mostly incorporated into. The dialogue changed, the discourse changed according to the needs of the time. So in the middle of the 19th century, when Emerson was writing, when he looked around his New England, there were these very poor people whom he did not consider Saxons. They were Celts, and they were immigrants. They were poor Irish immigrants. These were the famine immigrants. But by the end of the century, those people had children, and those children had gone to school, and they made their way up the economic ladder a little bit. That was one side of it. The other side was the turn of the 20th century brought a wave of new immigrants, people from Southern and Eastern Europe and the Near East. And so the former Celts as a separate race got tucked into American whiteness, not as Saxons, but as Nordics. So the 20th century term is Nordics, which has to do with Europeans from the northwest of Europe, which includes Ireland. So that was an incorporation of people who had been despised. So the early 20th century saw something that we can only call racism against immigrants, poor immigrants from Southern and Eastern Europe. And by the time their children and grandchildren were mobilized in the New Deal, in the Second World War, and then allowed to buy homes for white people only in the suburbs after the Second World War, then they become white people. And there's a large sort of passepartout whiteness that includes everybody. And that's the whiteness that we inherit in the 21st century. It's a whiteness that has also been buffeted around a bit. The taxonomists in the 18th century and the 19th century had a lot of trouble with Jews. Well, they were pretty much white people, but as we see in the United States, white was not enough to be the American or to be the right kind of American. But in taxonomical terms, were Jews Europeans? Well, yes, but. So in the early 20th century, the reigning scientific knowledge said that there were three European races: Teutonic, Alpine, and Mediterranean. Now, this left out two problem peoples. One was the Lapps, who were in and out and in and out, depending on the particular scheme, and the Jews, in and out and in and out, depending on the particular scheme. So it's really the Holocaust and then suburbanization that took away the racial taint. And I use taint because race is not always a taint. Took away the racial taint from Jewishness and left the quality of Jewish ethnicity. But there's changes have been occurring throughout the second half of the 20th century and into the 21st century. So for instance, people who are now the grandparent generation may well feel that they are not completely white, or they're white and Jewish, or they're mostly Jewish and they don't feel white. Their children probably feel both, maybe more white than Jewish, depending on how they were brought up. But the grandchildren probably just think of themselves as white people. And if they have one parent who's Jewish and one parent who's something else, especially if it's something else as attractive as Italian, they may well identify as Italian-American. Well, both at the same time. The idea of the American, for Emerson, there was not a problem. The American was a Saxon, and he was a man, and he was educated. By the 20th century, the American, you might kind of put women in, still pretty much male, but still definitely white, but not a Saxon anymore. We live in a world in which it's harder to talk about the American in the singular. So we're a multi. We have several different people who represent the United States. So in that sense, whiteness, the salience, the importance of whiteness is kind of tamping down some. On the other hand, the idea of blackness, that is poor, dark-skinned people, I think we will have that with us always. And when we, particularly at this moment of economic crisis and this moment in which we have a small number of very rich people and a lot of people who are kind of scraping by, and then tremendous differences, we have a great inequality of wealth and income. This group of people who were scraping by, there will be a lot of them, but they will probably be largely black and brown. And that will tend to reinforce racial ideas. So on the upper strata, among these few people up here who are doing very well, there will be people of various colors and from various backgrounds, but they will probably not be so racialized as the people who are not doing well.